Thank you so much for the participation. I have a few remarks to give to end this session of English language. First and foremost, candidates, I want to assure you, teachers have done whatever they can to prepare you very well for the final examination. So don't fear exams. Those very questions you have been finding in the course of learning right from P1 to primary 7. Maybe I can say, be confident. I've liked the kind of those participants have been here. Much as some answers are not right, they have been very confident. So on that day, I want to say, be confident and apply some few rules, like I would say, the three R's. The three R's, you need to mention in the full is, read, read, read. That is three R's. It is read, read, read. That means you should always read the question at least three times and allow the brain to digest the question, and then later on find out the answer and give the correct answer. I can also say that there are components in English which is not people are talking.
Silence.
Audience may have just a few minutes off. The components which I want you to follow in English language, so as to excel, one is punctuation. You cannot pass a number in English language unless you have punctuated very well. You have observed the necessary punctuation marks, either full stop, a comma, a question mark, a quotation marks, and the rest. So punctuation is very well. Two, spellings. Spellings almost constitute 90% of your passing in examinations. So may you mind the spellings. And before you give any spelling of any word, think twice. See the root word and see which word comes out of that word. And then later on, find out from the question what is a keyword in the question. And then you find out the right word and give the answer. Maybe also I cannot say good letter formation. I want to encourage you, write your work very well, because work written badly cannot earn you marks. I want to say shape your letters very well, write those letters correctly, and at the end of it, you'll convince the examiner to give you the marks. So handwriting is very important during the examination. Also can say that good sentence construction, if your sentences are very clumsy, forget marks. You must write upright, accurate sentences. That sentence must start always with a question. So I want to say that as you answer, maybe in section B, as you have read the passages, the poems, notices, advertisement, and the other texts given to you, may you answer your questions very correctly so that it tallies with your answer correctly to try with the question. I can also add and say, may you look at the tense. Without following the tense in the question, boys and girls, candidates, you cannot get a mark. So as you answer for the right tense in the question, that suits the answer. Also, I treat the question independently. I've seen here somebody who came to answer a question. He was looking at a question which maybe we have just done in class. For example, does you go to town with? When a preposition is given the question already, we have what we call that pronouns. We have who, we have whose, we have whom. In this aspect, when a preposition is already given a question, like with, is already there in the question, we don't use whom, we use the who. It is working as a subject in the sentence. Who did you go to town with? But if not there, it will be with whom did you go to town, in case he was not given a question. So learn to read questions very, very carefully, identify the tricks which the examiner has employed, and then find out the answer to give. And finally, because of time, I want to say that may you go back to rule number one. This is my general rule I give my children, the three R's. When I say three R's, read, read, read. Reading means you have to read every part in the examination paper. Whether that is the instructions, please read every part of the paper. In the instructions, always we have words like write giving or give one word. Children normally lose marks in terms of either rewrite or give. Where they tell to write, please write the sentence. What did you give? One word? Please give one word. So you must be in the know that the moment you are told to rewrite and you give, you can't get a mark. The moment you are told to give and you write, you don't get a mark for that answer. So I want to say that instructions are also very important. Mind the instruction and underline the key word in every instruction so that you can identify the right choice of answer which the examiner wants from you. And finally, I want to say, manage time. Most of us don't take time as very important. Time is a factor in terms of excellence. If you want to excel, please manage your time. Like you are given here 1 minute, almost we are very lenient. Some people have been taking 2 minutes, even more than that. When you manage time, you don't waste time on difficult questions. Read once, read it twice. The third time you're not getting it, please move on. Then later come back when you have made up your mind to give the right answer. So I would like to wish you the best in the coming examination. Do not panic. Please, you are going to excel. May God bless you, everybody.
Yes, that's Mr. Ituma Johnson from Green Hill Academy, a teacher. Thanks for participating. Nyinga is in Mukono District, Mukono, or Buikwe District? Buikwe District. Thanks for traveling and coming. This is the second time around when these were coming. Meanwhile, as those ones receive certificates, let me call upon Kingsway Primary School. Dennis Weldek Rosu. Who is the Dennis? Dennis Roderick. You are the one? Dennis Roderick. What is your son named Dennis?
Rosu.
Rosu. Meanwhile, let's receive also Sam from Budo Junior School, Asim Sinde Mary Kevin, followed by Afayo Lucky Gideon Aruho. All these ones said they wanted to be doctors. Susie James Jonathan, Afayo, how are you? Can you wave to the people? That is Afayo. Afayo, how old are you?
13 years old.
Is it a lie? He's 13. Afayo, thanks for participating. Yeah, Otim Isaac. Hey. He minds, eh? He cares, maybe. Something like that. With that, could I invite all those who have participated with their trophies and come for a group photo with the whole team, with the judges? Can you have come for a group photo in front of us, in front of the audience here for our records? Can you all come with your certificates, with your gifts, and we have a group photo with all the team. Those who have participated, please come for a group photo. However, I thank Chitante Primary School for hosting us. I thank all those people who have come and participated. I thank the judges. I thank everybody for your patience. Morning is not near. Those of you came from far. People came from Masaka, Mukono, etc. Those who got awards, come with them. You pick your awards and place them in front. Those who have got certificates, you put them up.